Hello Cravers, this is episode 3 of our space series. To coincide with the 50th anniversary of the Apollo 11 space missions, we remember 10 of the animals that took one giant leap into space and often lost their lives in the process. In July 1969, Apollo 11 launched into space and Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin successfully performed the first crewed lunar landing. Television images of the men taking humankind's very first steps on the moon's surface were broadcast into the homes of millions. But there were many animals that paved the way to this momentous occasion and many that furthered astronautical studies afterwards. First one are fruit flies. It was 1947 when the first animal was put into space. And perhaps surprisingly, it was the humble fruit fly. American scientists were trying to establish the impact that cosmic radiations might potentially have on astronauts in the future. They chose flies because they are genetically similar to humans. A V-2 ballistic missile recovered from the Nazis at the end of WW2 was loaded with the fruit flies and traveled 109 km into the air, the distance at which space officially begins. On this descent back to Earth, a capsule containing the flies was parachuted down to New Mexico. On opening the capsule, the scientists found the flies alive. With no evidence of the effects of radiation, it was the start of a long line of astronaut animals to come. Number 2. Monkeys and apes. Incredibly, 32 monkeys and apes have been to space, including the rhesus macaque, pig-tailed monkey, cynomolgus monkey, squirrel-tailed monkey, and chimpanzees. The very first was rhesus macaque called Albert II. In 1949, he reached 134 km but sadly died on impact when re-entering the Earth's atmosphere due to a parachute failure. He was preceded by Albert I a year earlier, who suffocated within his cramped capsule before it had even left the ground. Number 3. Mice. These rodents have long been used to find out more about how space travel will affect the human body. In fact, NASA has recently published a detailed study of mice housed at the International Space Station. It shows that mice quickly adapt to microgravity conditions. The very first mouse went into space in 1950, reaching an altitude of 137 km. However, unlike the fruit flies, the mouse died when the rocket disintegrated due to a parachute failure. Number 4. Dogs. A number of dogs has gone into space under the former Soviet Union. The most well-known are Laika in 1957. She was picked up off the streets as a stray mongrel puppy in Moscow and was deemed suitable because of her gentle temperament. The scientists also believed a stray would be better at coping with adverse conditions. Though other dogs have been launched into space before her, Laika is famous for being the first animal to orbit the Earth. However, she was never to return. She was sent off with just one meal and a 7-day oxygen supply. The Soviet government claimed she survived for 7 days. But the reality, Laika overheated, died just 5 hours into the flight. Number 5. Tortoise. In 1968, the race was on between the USA and Soviet Union to get a man on the moon. The Russians launched the Juno 5 spaceship with a capsule carrying samples of soil and seeds, some worms and 2 steppe tortoises. The tortoise completed a circuit around the moon and after 6 days returned to Earth. Though the plan had been for Juno 5 to land in Kazakhstan, the capsule verged off course and was eventually retrieved from the Indian Ocean. Thankfully, the tortoises were still alive though they had lost weight by 10%. Number 6. Frogs. These amphibians have been helping make one great leap for mankind since 1959. However, the most significant frog flight came in 1970 when NASA launched the orbiting frog Olotheith spaceship containing 2 bullfrogs. The word Olotheith refers to the frog's inner ear balance mechanism, and the experiment was designed to investigate the effect of space travel on motion sickness. Electrodes were implemented into the frog's thoraxes and vestibular system within the ear to record data on the effects of sustained weightlessness. The study found that after 6 days, the frogs assimilated and their vestibular system had returned to normal. Number 7. Spiders. After the success of the first manned mission to the moon in 1969, there were less emphasis on putting animals into space. However, scientists were still interested in studying the effects of microgravity on the biological functions of animals. In 1973, two garden spiders called Anita and Arabella were used in an experiment to see if they could still spin webs in space. The experiment was the brainchild of Massachusetts High School student Judith Miles. Both spiders managed to spin webs. Even though the webs were slightly finer than on Earth, the study revealed a great deal about the effects of microgravity on motor response. Number 8. Fish. The first aquanauts to reach space were a type of minnow found in salt marshes, the Munichog plus 50 eggs. It was 1973 and NASA were keen to observe the effects of microgravity on animals that move three-dimensionally on Earth. The human astronauts suffered from space sickness and likewise the fish swam in loops rather than straight lines. In a few days, both the astronauts and aquanauts had got their bearings. More recently, in 2012, the Japanese Space Agency decided to send fish up to the International Space Station. Their aquarium had an automatic feeding system, a water circulation system, and an LED light to represent day and night. The fish chosen to go up were Medaka, which have transparent skin, making it easier for researchers to see what was going on inside the fish. The purpose of the experiment was to see how fish would respond to radiation's impact, bone degradation, and muscle wastage. Number 9. Tardigrades. In 2007, tardigrades were the first animals to survive outer space. Tardigrades, also known as water bears, are microscopic invertebrates able to deal with almost anything on Earth, so perhaps it's not surprising. Lack of oxygen, radiation, freezing cold, dehydration, nothing phases a tardigrade. The tardigrades were dried out before the flight and then orbited the Earth outside the rocket for 10 days. When they were rehydrated on their return to Earth, scientists discovered 68% have survived the extreme cold and space radiation. Number 10. Nematodes. In 2003, the Columbia Space Shuttle disintegrated when it re-entered the Earth's atmosphere. Tragically, 7 astronauts on board were killed. There were 80 science experiments aboard the shuttle as well. Incredibly, when these were recovered from the wreckage, a live group of nematodes were found to have survived the extreme heat. Now, nematodes, also called roundworms, are often used to study the impact of space travel on organisms.
First films of one of the most amazing rocket experiments to date. At White Sands, New Mexico, Air Force scientists prepare to launch a rocket into upper space manned by 2 white mice and Albert the monkey. The purpose? To study their reactions to travel at altitudes and speeds never attained by human beings. Every precaution is taken to assure their return safe and sound from their spectacular journey into space to the point where the force of gravity measures exactly zero. The final step, inserting a tube of oxygen. Where this rocket is headed, there's no air outside. 0 hour approaches. They're off at 2,000 miles an hour. Special equipment broadcasts Albert's physical reactions back to the test station. Defense Department films show the rocket 38 miles up. Inside the missile, an automatic camera shows the mice running on the sides of their cage. There's no gravity here, no up or down. Notice the floating ball. Scientists rush to the scene and discover the animal crew has weathered the flight safely. It's Albert's moment of triumph. He's the world's first space cadet.
Hands all around, he is true to his nickname, Ham, a happy show-off. concerned at the mounting tension around him as he arrives in typical high spirits for his final checkup.
A month after the first launching, the second Sputnik was sent up.